What's going on, folks? It's your boy Black Phoenix coming live to you from Hog on World and LLC. And today I just wanted to talk about getting started as a welder, as an independent welder. I was asked by several people to kind of describe how I got started and got into the process of being independent and getting into the welding field, getting bids, getting jobs. Well, as of right now, I'm more or less freelancing. I got my LLC started. I went and got my certifications, my AWS certifications, which I've been welding now over 10 years. But I have only been AWS certified while I'm actually carrying my certs around 2 years now. Normally, you'll get certified through the company you're working with, and they keep your cert, so you won't be able to take them with you. Needless to say, you need to invest in that. Another big thing to do is just ask yourself a simple question. What kind of welder do you want to be? You have your shutdown welders. You have your field welders, erectors. You have your shop welders, fabricators. And you have your independent welders, rig welders. And each position requires something different. And also, each position pays differently. So, if you want to get into some real money, I would be an independent welder, rig welder. My personal opinion. Most factories don't pay a lot, or they'll top out at a certain level where you won't be able to grow. You just get to that certain point and that's just where you at. If that's where you want to be, that's fine. But if you want to make money, see the world, I will focus more on the field welding and the rig welding side and the fabrication, because fabrication is very, very important. So if you're a good fabricator, you can make a lot of good money. So I would say I have been involved in all fields. I have done shops, mills, companies, industries, industrial. And after working for someone for so long, I realized that I could do more and make more if I invest in myself. I invest in my equipment, I invest in my my certs, on top of me already having the knowledge from working under someone else for so many years, of learning the business and keeping my eyes open on what not to do. Just a combination of things. But being here in Arizona has allowed me to see things differently and build a different market than what I'm used to, because I'm from Arkansas. So from Arkansas and Missouri is different than out here in the West. So, you know, I'm used to the Arkansas, Missouri way, and now I'm out here, you know, in the West, and things are completely different. The pay range is not too different, but the work ethics are different. So being out here, I have learned that my work ethics is setting me aside from other people and other companies. So as of right now, I'm doing a lot of freelance and going in, helping people or companies that are behind, contractors who need a project welded up, done, but they're behind, or someone to show up or whatever need be. That's what I'm doing now, so I can learn the city. Like I said, I do have my LLC, I do have my banking account, my EIN, all my tools, but I don't know if I want to be a contractor yet. I'm right now focusing more on the service provider and product side, because I'm thinking there'll be more money in that and less headache than actually just being a contractor. True, you know, the bids are bigger. You can able to get some big money real quick, but also doing what I do, or specializing in filling that void, I also think that your money can come from doing that. So I'm trying to figure that field out, you know, figure that niche out. But if I would have any advice to give to someone fresh out of school or someone who woke up and said, hey, I'm ready to get some money, I'm ready to see the world, I'm ready, ready to build something, it's possible. It's most definitely possible. Counting assets and the stuff we invested in, me and my wife, going on the road, we did from making 20,000, I say 40,000 a year between both of us, to hitting 100K. So it's most definitely possible. But the thing is now is, you know, using those assets, getting started in a new area. So now I'm just kind of learning the field, getting my, I guess, getting my hands wet, figuring out my niche here in Arizona, here in Phoenix. So, like I say, as of right now, I think I'm leaning towards the product and service. So when you enter into this world and game to be independent, you must ask yourself, what kind of world do you want to be? You know, do you just want to work for others? Do you want to have your own tools and equipment and make more money? Do you just want to use it as a side hustle? But it's most definitely a positive career. You just have to tap into it and not be scared to make sacrifices and invest in yourself, because at the end of the day, that's the most important thing, is to invest in yourself. When after you have invested in yourself to pull all that knowledge and that time and those materials together and build what you want. And like we say, and I tell everybody else, you know, whatever you do, live to be remembered in.